So a few years ago I had a GT86, and to get into the Christmas spirit I decided to wrap it in, well, wrapping paper. The year after I had to step my game up, so I set to work covering it in Christmas lights, and I've gotta say the results were mega. It was a pretty good looking car to start with, but after taping 50 metres worth of fairy lights to it and driving around town for a few hours, blasting Mariah Carey out the windows, it became a certified neck snapper. The 86 is gone now, but I was in the loft getting the decorations down the other day, and there they were, the abandoned Christmas lights. And I think it's only right that we do it properly this time rather than just getting a couple of lousy pictures. So strap yourselves in because this one's gonna be festive as fuck. Before I get started, I just want to say a massive thanks to everyone who subscribed to the channel over the past 8 months. I really do appreciate the support of everyone, and since it's Christmas, I want to give a little something back to you. There's this up-and-coming website that you might have heard of. It's called Amazon, and you can buy pretty much anything you want from on there. Emphasis on the anything. Do you need a pair of sliders in the shape of a fish? Or maybe a squirrel feeder that's made to look like a horse's head? Well, I'm going to give away a £20 gift voucher to one lucky subscriber when the counter ticks over to 1,000. And all you've got to do to enter is subscribe to the channel and comment down below what you'd spend the 20 notes on. I'd personally go for these finger hands. You know, hands for your fingers. Why, you might ask? Because I like to invest my money wisely, that's why. I'll leave the details down in the description, so go get yourself involved. Right, let's get back to the reason why you're here in the first place. Like I said earlier, I no longer own my GT86. Instead, I've got this. The Boost Bus. If you want to have a better look around the swaggin, I'll leave a link to the walkaround that I did in the description too. Fingers crossed I can replicate the reactions I got the other year in the 86 with this big boy. What it lacks in looks, it more than makes up for in size.
That's what she said!
So when this great thing's lit up, no one's gonna be able to miss it. Hopefully, anyway. The thing is though, I bought enough lights to cover the last car, and this one's about 13 metres longer, so I guess I'll have to go buy some more. Another great investment? The other thing I'll be needing is tape, and lots of it. I stuck the lights on with white lecky tape last time and it worked a treat. It holds them on really well, and the best thing is you can peel it off easy and it leaves no mess. Always thinking ahead. Before all the car guys start crying about my paintwork, just remember this. It's my car! And I'm pretty good at doing this now, so don't worry about it. At least you can mop your tears up with one of your microfiber drying towels. Once I spent approximately 7 hours untangling the lights from the loft, I set to work sticking them on the car. Now, there isn't a specific technique for something like this, you just throw them on there and stick them down. In fact, not knowing what you're doing seems to get the best results. Now I might be a bit biased, but I think it turned out even better than last time, and I didn't even come close to using all the lights. I just ran out of light to put them all on in. The plan for the night was to pick up a group of my mates, and then drive around a few towns to see what kind of reactions we'd get, and that's what we did. Most people just stopped dead in the tracks, others were pointing the car out to the friends, and when we were parked up there were crowds of people gathering around to get photos. In hindsight, I should have mounted a GoPro or something to the car instead of asking the lads to film. They're usually pretty reliable with the camera, but every time I stopped for people to get pictures, they legged it into the nearest bar. So by the end of the night, well, let's just say the footage wasn't up to their own standards. Nevertheless, everybody loved it, and I think it's safe to say it got people in the mood for Christmas if they weren't already, so mission complete. On the way home, we headed over to the infamous Infinity Bridge spot and recreated last year's pictures, so I've got another one for the album, but you know what they say, third time's a charm, so let's see what happens next year. Anyway, I really hope you enjoyed this video, I had an absolute blast making it. If you want to see more content like this and also enter the giveaway, which I mentioned earlier on in the video, remember to subscribe to the channel and leave your comments down below. I'll see you in the next one. Merry Christmas! Bye!